What's going on, people? And a new bit of content to the channel today. For those of you that don't know, I used to play basketball a lot also when I was little against blokes and held my own in terms of skill. I've always been pretty good at basketball, especially from the 3-point line. So yeah, I've got a bit of natural ability for basketball. Grew up on it. My brother was heavily into basketball, had a chance to go to university and do it. He didn't do it, unfortunately, but had the opportunity. So grew up playing, my older brother played a lot, had a lot of influence, posters in his room growing up, Kobe, Mike, Muggsy Bowes, like, I've always loved basketball. Lost a bit of interest in it for a few years, but come back to it a few years back now and get back into it. Very excited for the season to start. I'll be watching the Lakers versus the Nuggets tonight. I'd love to go to a game. I've always said if I was American, I'd definitely have a season ticket for a basketball team. My team are the Chicago Bulls because of Michael Jordan, grew up on that, Scottie Pippen, Dennis Rodman. So Chicago Bulls are my team. And this is my NBA predictions for the new season. Hope you guys enjoy it. So first up, I'm going through the conferences, who I think will be in the top six seeds, and then the play-in for both conferences. And then I'll get into the individual things like MVPs, who I think will win, who will be the champs, the runners-up, best record and worst record. So, first off, starting in the Eastern Conference, in the first seed, I've got the Celtics. They're going to be hungry for it. Came close last year. Tatum is desperate for a championship, and I think Jaylen Brown is as well. I think they're a good duo, a good partnership. They have lost Marcus Smart, which I think is a big loss, but they've got Porzingis in now as well, which I think will add. I think Pritchard at the point as well is improving a lot. They've lost Brogdon as well, though, which I think is a big loss also. But they brought Porzingis in, as I said. I feel like Pritchard is improving. Got that Williams there as well, if he can stay fit. I was impressed with him last season, but a lot of people predicting MVP for Tatum, and I'm not mad at it. He's one of my favourite players, and I think he could potentially get it this year. But they're going to be desperate for a title. I'll get into Celtics in a little bit as well, a bit more. But they are my first seed for the Eastern Conference Finals. Second seed, I've gone with Milwaukee Bucks. Damian Lillard, obviously, finally leaving Portland. One of my favourite players in the league, Lillard. Always has been. I think he's going to be a massive asset to the Bucks. With Antetokounmpo there as well. People like Middleton. I think Crowder as well is a vital player for them. I think they're going to have a decent season. They could get to the finals themselves, but I think they might just miss out. But I think bringing Lillard in, big, big asset for them. They have lost Drew Holiday, but that was another one for the Celtics as well. Just going back to the Celtics, they brought in Drew Holiday, which I think is an underrated pick as well. Getting drafted to the Celtics, I think he's a quality player. Lillard going to the Bucks, I think he will boost them. Obviously, they won a few years back, title. Antetokounmpo has got one. Lillard's never got one, though, and I think that he'll be desperate to get one. I think they have a good chance, but I've got them second seed. Number three, I've gone with the New York Knicks. Big fan of Brunson. Loving what he's doing there. And I think that they'll have a decent season. And I think that they'll get to maybe the quarters or the semis. So, Knicks, third place. Fourth place, I've gone with the Cavaliers. Garland, decent player. Donovan Mitchell, obviously, if he can stay fit, is vital to them. I like Mobley. I like a few of the Cavalier players, so I think that they can have a decent season if their players can stay fit. I've gone with a fourth seed. 76ers, obviously, is a lot of commotion at the moment with James Harden. I don't think that we'll probably see him for them again. But they have got Joel Embiid at centre. Obviously, the MVP, reigning MVP. He's going to be desperate to get to a final and win it. I'm not so sure, though. If Harden goes, I think that they'll miss him, even though there's a lot of controversy around him. They've got Tyrese Maxey, good youngster. People like Tobias Harris, veteran, knows his role, plays it well. But I think that they'll struggle. I feel like they're, obviously, I've got them in the top six seed in fifth. But I don't think that they'll get to a semis or a final, to be honest. So Embiid, I think on a personal level, will have a decent season. But I think the rest of the squad might struggle a bit. Fifth seed, Sixers. Sixth seed, I've gone with the Miami Heat. Jimmy Buckets, playoff time, we all know what to expect from him. I think they'll just about do enough to get into the playoffs, so I've got them in sixth place. Tyler Hero coming back from a long injury. They have lost Gabe Vincent, though, which I think is a big loss. But they've got Adebayo at centre, decent, and Butler, like I said. So I think they'll do all right. Sixth seed, Eric Spoelstra as well, one of the best coaches in the league for me, underrated. Into the play-ins then for the Eastern. I've gone 7th seed, the Pacers. If they can keep Halliburton fit, I think he will be the main force in that team and driving them into the play-in and hopefully getting into later stages of the season. 8th seed, I've gone with the Hawks. Obviously, a lot of that is going to come down to Trae Young, but I think that they can go under the radar a bit and probably do something. So the Hawks at 8th, Raptors at 9, Scotty Barnes there. I think he is a decent youngster coming through at the moment. I think he's just building and building season upon season. And Anunoby, I think, is a decent player that they've got there. Obviously, they've got the veteran in Siakam as well. So I think that they've got enough mix there to be a decent team. And I think their home crowd advantage as well through the season will help. So Raptors in at 9th. And then 10th, I've gone probably with a little bit of a surprise package to even get in the play-ins. But just got Jordan Poole, and that's the Washington Wizards. Poole, a big fan of him. A little bit surprised, even with all the stuff with Draymond in last season with the Warriors, that they got rid of him, because I think he is a vital player and the points he can bring. But I think he'll star for Wizards. I think he'll be their star player. Got him in at 10th. Into the Western Conference then. In at first seed, I've gone with the Denver Nuggets. I just think they're a brilliant side. Obviously, the reigning champs. Just quality all round, I feel like. Depth, Mike Malone as the coach as well. Very underrated, I think. Nuggets first place. Second place, I've gone with the LA Lakers. I think LeBron will have a good season. I feel like people like Vanderbilt that they brought in will be good. Gabe Vincent, I think, is going to be a steal for them. Austin Reeves, I think, will just get better and better. I like their team. I like the mix of youth and experience, and I think that they're going to have a decent season. So second for the Lakers. Warriors in at number 3. Obviously, Steph Curry, Klay Thompson, Draymond still there with the experience. Obviously, they brought in Chris Paul at point as well, so that'll free up Curry in a sense of just not having to bring the ball up the court in a point guard position, and I think he'll thrive from that as well. So third place for Warriors, but wouldn't be surprised if they could go higher. In at number 4, I've gone with the Phoenix Suns. Obviously, Devin Booker will now probably play as the point guard after losing Chris Paul. Ayton has gone, obviously, but I feel like Booker, bringing in Bradley Beal as well, I think Booker, Beal and Durant as the big three there, I think they'll have a decent season. And yeah, I've gone 4th place. I think that they could go pretty far. Kings in at number 5. Big fan of the Sacramento Kings after what they did last season as well. Really like Fox there. Like Monk. So yeah, I think they're going to have a decent season again and try and build on what they did last year. 5th place for me, Kings. Number 6, I've gone with the Memphis Grizzlies. Just brought in Marcus Smart from the Celtics. I think he is going to be a steal for them at the point. Offers a lot of experience as well, that veteran role. And I think he's a very underrated player and always has been. Obviously, Ja Morant, it's going to be interesting to see what they do with him. Obviously, they lost Dylan Brooks, which I think will be a bit of a loss for them, to be honest. I know he's controversial, but I think he's a decent player and he's a workhorse. But I like Jackson Jr. there as well. Bane, I think they got a decent squad, decent coach, and they're just rough, gritty and can get it done. So 6th seed Grizzlies for me. And then the play-in in the Western, I've gone for 7th Clippers. If Kawhi can stay fit, I think that's going to play a major role in their season. Obviously, Paul George, quality player, but it's mainly on Kawhi and if he can stay fit. I do like Zubac at centre as well. So, yeah, it depends on their fitness, some of their players for me, how they will do. Bones Highland, big fan of him. So, yeah, I've gone with 7th for Clippers. 8th seed, I've gone with the Pelicans. Obviously, they were joint first last season in the regular season for a bit. And then Zion got injured and then they started to slip. But Ingram, I think, is a brilliant player for them, consistent. But it's all going to depend, similar to the Clippers with Kawhi. It's going to be like Zion with the Pelicans. If he can stay fit, he boosts them a lot. I've gone with them for 8th seed. 9th seed, I've gone with the Dallas Mavericks. Doncic, quality player, but doesn't always show up. Most of the time he does, but Irving, obviously, if he can stay fit, I think is vital. But I don't feel like he's gelling with Doncic on a personal level to the level they would like. And because of that, I doubt it a bit on how far they can go. But I think they get the play-in at least at minimum. So Doncic, obviously, massive scorer for them. But I think they'll struggle a bit. Mavericks, 9th seed. And 10th seed, I've gone with maybe a little bit of a surprise for some people. because I did want to include the Timberwolves, but it's tough. There's a few teams in there that I think could make that play-in. And I did want to include the Timberwolves with obviously Towns there. They've got Gobert and obviously Edwards. But something's telling me OKC. So I went with OKC. I love Giddey there. I think he's decent. I really think Holmgren will get the... I know it was his rookie season last year, but he hardly played. So I'm counting him as a rookie this year. And I think he will get rookie of the year. Shai Gilgeous-Alexander at point is just unbelievably underrated. So I think they're going to have a decent season and do a minimum play-in and maybe potentially go further. So OKC is my kind of underrated, under-the-radar team for this season going forward, but was tempted to put the Timberwolves in there, but went with the Thunder. And then for the MVP, nothing to see here. I've gone with Jokic. I think he should have got it last season, to be honest. I'm not mad that Embiid got it. I think Jokic should have got it, to be honest, and I think he'll get it this year. Finals, I've actually gone with the Celtics against the Lakers, so I do think the Nuggets will just miss out in the semis. But I've gone with the Celtics versus the Lakers, old school rivalry, Tatum versus LeBron. Champs, I've actually gone. Champions, then, I've actually gone with the Lakers to win it. I want the, I would prefer the Celtics too, but I think the Lakers, something's telling me that they're going to do it. So I think Austin Reeves will be a vital player for them this season, and I feel like they've got that grit that they need to get it done. And obviously LeBron, what he can offer. Anthony Davis is a big one. If he can stay fit, I think he'll make a crucial difference. And people like Vanderbilt, as I spoke about earlier, and Gabe Vincent, I think, is going to be a vital player. I'm going with the Lakers to win it all. Runners-up, Celtics, obviously, but I would like them to do it just to get over that final hurdle. I think Brown and Tatum deserve it, to be honest. But they'll be my runners-up for me. Best record for the league, I'm going with the Nuggets in terms of the regular season and then playoffs, but I don't think that they will win the whole thing. But all-round record, I think the Nuggets. And then the worst record, I've gone with the Pistons. It was between them and probably someone like the Rockets for me, but I've gone with the Pistons for the worst record, but... bit of a lottery for that one. Hope you enjoyed it, guys. Let me know yours in the comments, what your predictions are for the season. And I'll be back at some point with more NBA content. Excited for the season to start. Hope you enjoy it.